Hey everybody, welcome to PC Perspective. I'm Ryan Schrout. Today is a somber day at the PC Perspective offices. We're going to have an unboxing for you, something we don't usually do. But this, as you can see, is a special case. This is a new inbox Voodoo 3 2000 PCI graphics card that was sent to us quite a long time ago by a viewer reader who I apologize, I couldn't try to find his name and through previous emails and could not find it. And it rested wonderfully in its place here, both on our new set and just throughout, and it was endeared and viewed by many people that came through our office. However, recently we had a small water issue with the condo above us, and this box is now totally ruined and waterlogged inside and out. So we thought we'd take this opportunity to go ahead and do an unboxing, explain to you all about the wonders of the Voodoo 3 2000 PCI. And I figured obviously this needs to start with just looking through the box. Before I do that, I am going to remove the plastic so that the camera can see it a little bit better. It's important to note this was original shrink wrap. We even still have a Voodoo 3 2000 and 3000 $30 mail-in rebate offer on this that apparently was good until September 18th, 1999. So there's that. So let's go ahead and take this plastic off. I feel very guilty about having to do this, but I think having the card sit inside of a basically destroyed cardboard box is sadder. So I'm going to save this rebate and I'm going to send it in to really what I think of as the only remaining part of 3DFX, which is Brian Burke over at NVIDIA. And there's a mailing address here and they need a UPC and a store receipt. But I think maybe they'll look past the store receipt for us there. So here's our box, Voodoo 3 2000 PC. You can see it's very wrinkly. If we look through some of these specifications, and we are looking at a PCI 2.1 graphics card with 16 megs of SD RAM and a core clock speed of 143 megahertz, supporting DirectX Glide and OpenGL, and vertical refresh rates as high as 160 hertz, but they probably didn't have variable refresh back then. Lots of cool, interesting feature sets on this for what it's worth today. Patented single pass, single cycle multi-texturing, dual 32-bit texture rendering pipelines, alpha blending, single pass, single cycle, bump mapping, a lot of that type of stuff. Really, the marketing lingo on the back is where it's at, though. We got to talk about this being, unless you've lived under a rock, you know that most games are made for Voodoo technology. This is part of 3DFX's wonderful marketing campaigns. They've got the subtle curves of Tomb Raider on the back of the box. They've got a Mech Warrior back here, a baseball game of some kinds using the bump mapping technology. They just don't make boxes like this anymore. So I guess we just need to go ahead and open this box. I'm trying to think if there's a less destructive way to do this than how I had originally planned it, but it doesn't appear to be that way. There we go. The water log hadn't completely re-glued everything. This is the first time this video card's seeing light. Uh-oh. All right, let's take all of our dirty water accessories out of here. All right, we've got our iDOS demo disc that includes Tomb Raider 2, 3, and Gold, Final Fantasy 7, Warzone 2100, Revenant, Daikatana, Braveheart, Thief, Gangsters, Commandos, Legacy of Kain, in Omicron. You don't get demo discs like that anymore. We've got our registration card for MPEG and DVD, MPEG 2 DVD software. I don't think you can really get a hold of 3DFX offices there. There's an ad for a desktop TV remote control, because TV was so yesterday, is the marketing lingo there. We've got our actual technical support registration card and a FCC compliance statement for the Voodoo 3 2000 PCI. Got our quick install guide, which uses pretty cool caricatures of video cards in there. Having to deal with and getting people to install it into the right slot, AGP or PCI, I imagine was pretty complicated. And then a driver disk, version 1.01, supporting Windows 95, 98, and NT4 with DirectX 6 installer on there as well. So here she is. Voodoo 3 2000 PCI and all of its kind of glary glory inside this plastic case. And there it goes. Let's go ahead and take her out of there. move that out of the way. It smells like brand new electronics still. Here she is, Voodoo 3 2000 PCI. Look how far graphics cards have come, guys. This was passively cooled by this tiny heatsink here. And that's, you got one video output, one SVGA video output. I did a little pre-research here trying to figure out exactly how this GPU stacks up in today's modern world. This is a PCI graphics card, as you can see. It had 143 megahertz clock speed, a 300 megahertz RAM DAC, which was actually much more important back in those days. This could do 6 million triangles per second. For comparison, the current GeForce GTX Titan X can do well over 2 billion triangles per second with tessellation support in there. This has 16 megs of SD RAM. The Titan X has 12 gigabytes of GDDR5. This retailed on launch, by the way, it launched in April of 1999, sold for $129. This was not the highest-end Voodoo 3 card. The highest-end Voodoo 3 card sold for $249, actually. So the Titan X sells for $1,000. The 980 Ti sells for $650. So prices have definitely gone up. And I did a quick inflation check. And $129 converts all the way up to $186. So there's still a lot of room to make up there. But you can see how simple these boards are. You're not really worried about power delivery in any instance like that. In the back of the board, completely bare as well. Passive, single slot, Voodoo 3. Now, this is an interesting card in the 3DFX lineup. This wasn't the death knell of Voodoo or 3DFX. That was the Voodoo 5 product that really did that to 3DFX. This instead had its own controversy, whereas some of the internal pipelines actually operated at 32-bit pixel quality, or color quality rather, but it was in order to save frame buffer size, it actually dithered down to 16 bits, but then the RAM DAC, the 300 megahertz RAM DAC, actually did some 2x2 or 4x1 filtering to bring it up to what 3DFX billed as quote-unquote 22-bit image quality, so that when you took screenshots in the game, they were actually a different quality than what was being shown on the screen. The screenshots in the game were taken from the frame buffer at 16-bit. What showed on the display was actually supposedly a little bit higher. So that was kind of the controversy that surrounded this card back in the day. That's pretty much it in terms of technical information I have for this, other than looking at it longingly. The next step we're going to take now is we're going to try to get this video card to run. We're going to install an older system with a PCI slot in it. We're going to put, I don't know, maybe Windows XP on a system and see if we can actually get the kind of user-created, fan-created drivers throughout the years to power this on, maybe play some Unreal Tournament. What were the other games at the time? We got Quake 2, Quake 3, Unreal Tournament, System Shock 2, maybe the original Half-Life, and all of its Glide glory. Let's see if that worked out. Well, as you can tell, the setup process took a little bit longer than we expected. It's a different day. I'm wearing different clothes. But the good news is we did get the Voodoo 3 2000 PCI graphics card up and running. There were a handful of hurdles, not the least of which was we had to find a motherboard with a PCI slot. We had to go back to Sandy Bridge, in our case, to find a board that we had here in the office. We had to find an optical drive to install Windows XP, which was the latest driver we were able to find. The community actually kept building drivers for quite a long time for this. The most recent one, I think, was in 2007, which is quite a bit after this card was released. So we did get Windows XP installed after a little bit of a headache there. We got a driver installed. And I found an ISO of Unreal Tournament Game of the Year Edition, came out in 1999. Installed it, loaded up, installed very quickly, mind you, because we had it hooked up to an SSD, and boom, up and running, out of the gate, no issues. You could run it at 800 by 600. You could run it at 1024 by 768. And it played very well, as you'd expect. Interesting little quirks about, like, hey, the WASD keys weren't default then. That was the arrow keys. That's interesting. Also, the software renderer that's using the CPU, pretty close in speed now that we're using a Sandy Bridge processor from 2011, 2012 on it in that case. We tried to install some other games, like I downloaded Steam and ran that. It caused blue screens. It kept rebooting the machine. So we kind of left it as where we are at now, proving that we could get this card up and running actively on our system. So that's it for our unboxing the Voodoo 3 2000 PCI, everybody. Sorry you can't buy this one. It's going to go in our kind of museum shelf over here, and hopefully I get that $30 rebate at the end of the day. Thanks.